Hello, beautiful people. In this section, I am going to explain a very interesting technology, that is Li-Fi technology, with a simple examples. Before getting into concepts, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and click on the notification so that you don't miss any updates from our channel. Like the video if it found useful for you. Comment your queries. I will try to answer as soon as possible. Check the description section for more details. Let us get back to the concepts now. Li-Fi has been a buzzword for a few years now. So the first question to answer is, what is Li-Fi technology is all about? We all know Wi-Fi is a wireless technology which uses radio signals for data transmission, whereas Li-Fi is a wireless optical networking technology that uses light-emitting diodes, that is LEDs, for data transmission. So who doesn't love LEDs? They are bright, blinky, soft, and elegant. They are colorful. So Li-Fi is designed to use these LED light bulbs for data transmission. However, Li-Fi bulbs are prepared with a chip that modulates the light slowly for optical data transmission. Li-Fi data is transmitted by the LED bulbs and received by photoreceptors. Li-Fi's early development models are capable of 150 Mbps of speed. Some commercial kits enabling that speed have been released. In the lab, with stronger LEDs and different technology, researchers have enabled 10 Gbps, which is faster than 802.11ad, which is the latest standard in Wi-Fi technology. So precisely, Li-Fi, or light fidelity, which is an acronym for Li-Fi, invented by German physicist and professor Harald Haas, is a wireless technology that makes use of visible light in place of radio waves to transmit data at terabits per second speed, which is more than 100 times the speed of Wi-Fi. So this is some of the basic concepts that everyone must understand, because this gives you the actual difference between what is Li-Fi and what is Wi-Fi. So Wi-Fi basically uses radio waves in order to transmit the data, whereas the Li-Fi uses the medium light for the data transmission. So the next question to answer is, how basically the Li-Fi technology works? Now I'm going to explain what are the different components associated with the Li-Fi and how basically the Li-Fi technology works in the real world. Li-Fi is a visible light communication system. This means that it accommodates a photo detector to receive light signals and a signal processing element to convert that data into streamable content. See, what is important in any technology is to understand what component does what. So for example, here I am talking about a photo detector. So what it basically does is, photo detector will receive the light signals and a signal processing element which is being connected to the photo detector will be converting the data into streamable content. So unlike Wi-Fi, which uses radio waves, as I have already explained, Li-Fi runs on a visible light. In case of Li-Fi, data is fed into an LED light bulb with a signal processing technology. It then sends data, which is embedded in its beam at rapid speeds, to the photo detector, that is a photodiode. The tiny changes in the rapid dimming of light bulbs is then converted by the receiver into electrical signal. So the signal is then converted back into a binary data stream that the user would recognize as web, video, and audio applications that run on internet-enabled devices such as laptops, mobiles, IoT devices, etc. See, what is important here is, in whatever the form the signal is receiving, ultimately it has to be converted into ones and zeros, where ultimately your devices are going to understand all the data in the form of ones and zeros. So this is how basically the Li-Fi technology is going to work. Initially, the data will be fed into an LED light bulb, and then it sends its data at rapid speeds to the photo detector. Then the tiny changes in the rapid dimming of LED bulbs is then converted by the receiver into electrical signal, and this signal has to be converted into binary data stream that the user would recognize as data, video or audio applications that run on internet enabled devices. So the most important component in Li-Fi technology is LED. So we must be knowing that an LED light bulb is a semiconductor light source, meaning the constant current of electricity supplied to an LED light bulb can be dipped and dimmed up and down at extremely high speeds without being visible to the human eye. So you can just imagine that ones and zeros are like on and off. So in the case of an LED bulb, on is nothing but up and the zero is nothing but the down. So the LED bulbs will be up and down at extremely high speed without being visible to the human eye. So this is how basically the Li-Fi technology works. So let's understand some of the advantage. So any technology, if we consider, the most important thing is to understand where it is getting placed. So there are advantages, and as a technology, there are always limitations. So first of all, let's understand what are the advantages associated with the Li-Fi technology, and then we will talk about limitations of Li-Fi. So the Li-Fi could make a huge impact on the Internet of Things too. So we might be knowing by this time that what is IoT is all about. Suppose if you are not knowing, I'm going to make a video on IoT technology in few days. And also Li-Fi offers great promise to overcome the existing limitation of Wi-Fi by providing for data heavy communications in short ranges. So there is a lot of limitations that are associated with the Wi-Fi. So one limitation is the interference of the radio waves, and if there is an interference of the radio waves, there will be a lot of distortion. So Li-Fi offers a great promise to overcome such kind of limitations by providing heavy data communications in short ranges. Due to its short range, Li-Fi is more secure than Wi-Fi. Since it does not pollute, it can be called a green technology for device-to-device communication in the world of IoT. And also, Li-Fi system consumes less power. As we already know, the main reason why we are going to use the LED bulbs is because it consumes very less power. So hence, the same advantage is applicable to Li-Fi technology as well. So these are the series of advantages that we will find in the case of Li-Fi technology. Now coming to the limitations of Li-Fi. As visual light can't pass through opaque objects. So we already know that the properties of the visual light. So the main important property of the visual light is it cannot pass through opaque objects. So the same limitations lies in Li-Fi technology as well. As the visual light can't pass through opaque objects and needs line of sight for communication, its range will remain very restricted to start with. In order to enjoy full connectivity, more capable LED bulbs will need to be placed at various places. And Li-Fi requires light bulb is on at all times to provide connectivity, meaning that the lights will need to be on during the daytime. So which is not basically a good practice to save the electricity. So when we are switching on the lights on the daytime, and there will be a lot of waste in the electricity. Li-Fi is likely to face interference from external light sources such as sunlight and bulbs, and obstructions in the path of transmission, and hence may cause interruptions in communication. Also, initially there will be high installation cost of visual light communication system as an add-on to lighting systems. So these are the limitations. So when you compare the limitations and the advantage of the Li-Fi, so obviously the Li-Fi has more advantages, and some of the limitations what Li-Fi is having now can be eliminated in future. Till now we have seen what are the advantages and limitations with respect to Li-Fi, and there are certain potential challenges that are associated with the Li-Fi technology. Let's understand what are those. The main challenge is to create a Li-Fi ecosystem, which will need the conversion of existing smartphones into Li-Fi enabled ones by the use of converter and adapter. See, any technology when it comes, so ultimately the end devices must be compatible with the technology. For example, in the case of a Wi-Fi, whenever you are buying a mobile, so you basically see what are the Wi-Fi standards a mobile is going to support, like 802.11, A, B, G, N, or whatever it is. So in the same way, the mobile devices or the end devices has to support the Li-Fi technology with a specific standard. So that is the main challenge, that is to create a Li-Fi complete ecosystem which need the conversion of an existing smartphone or end devices into Li-Fi enabled ones by the use of converter or adapter. And the second challenge is an integrated chip that has both light to electrical conversion and data processing capability combined into one needs to be developed and manufactured in the millions. Any new devices which are coming, and these are the few challenges it is going to face. Of course, after a few years, once this technology becomes matured, then these challenges can be eliminated easily. So now we have understood most of the important concepts that are associated with the Li-Fi technology and what are the challenges that are associated with the technology. Now let's understand some of the potential applications of Li-Fi technology. So Li-Fi can be used in street and traffic lights. So whenever I'm explaining a concept, and just imagine that how the life would be when this particular technology comes live. So Li-Fi can be used in street and traffic lights. So traffic lights can communicate to the vehicles and with each other. Through the use of Li-Fi, traffic control can be made intelligent and real-time adaptable. And each traffic and street light post can be converted into access points to convert roadsides into wireless hotspots. Now we know that wireless hotspots are provided at the important points in the city. In the similar way, we can have each traffic and street light post can be converted into access points to convert roadsides into wireless hotspots. So another potential application is vehicles having LED based headlights and tail lamps can communicate with each other and prevent accidents by exchanging information. This is one of the interesting potential application that can be achieved using the Li-Fi technology. So visible light being safer, they can also be used in places where radio waves can't be used, such as petrochemical and nuclear plants and hospitals. And they can also be used in aircrafts where most of the control communication is performed through radio waves. So the Li-Fi can also easily work underwater where Wi-Fi fails completely, therefore throwing open endless opportunities for military and navigational operations. And also, it presents another unique possibility, that is transmitting power wirelessly, wherein the smartphones will not only receive data through Li-Fi, but will also receive power to charge itself. It seems very interesting when we talk about the potential applications of the Li-Fi technology. So if all these applications get converted into a real-time usable applications, then it would be wonder. I have explained most of the important features of Li-Fi technologies and what are the advantages, disadvantages, and potential applications with respect to the Li-Fi technology. To conclude this video, if Li-Fi can be put into practical use, every LED lamp, indoor as well as outdoor, can be converted into something like a hotspot to transmit data to every mobile devices to achieve universal broadband communication between devices with very cheap cost. So that's all for this video. Put your comments if you have any queries. Like the video if it found useful for you. Let's meet in the next video. Thank you. Bye-bye.